Hello everyone and welcome back to another anatomy tutorial. This is Dr. Aiyan from the Veterinary Anatomy channel. A lot of students, they ask me if I can show some anatomical videos on animal models so it will be easier for them later to look for these structures on real animal cadavers. So I will start with something I will show in this video here, and if you like the idea, please write in the comments in the way that I will apply this on some other videos on other animals. And today in this video we will talk about some of the muscles of the shoulder girdle muscles, the muscles which are important to connect the forelimb to the trunk, to the body, to the trunk, to the neck, and some of them to the head. And I will show you some trick in the way that we will look for the origin and insertion of these muscles. Let's start with the first muscle called the trapezius muscle. The trapezius muscle in all animals has two parts, the cervical part and the thoracic part. As you can see, these two are the trapezius muscle. The origin and insertion of this muscle, if we use this tool here, I can show you how the thoracic part of the trapezius muscle look. So this is the trapezius muscle thoracic part. It starts from the spinous processes of the thoracic vertebra, as you can see there, and goes all the way and inserts to the spine of the scapula, to this part of the spine of the scapula. So this is the thoracic part again, this one here. While the cervical part of the trapezius muscle start from the median rough and from the knuckle ligament, which we cannot see here because it's not a bone. And the cervical part of the trapezius muscle inserts also to the spine of the scapula, like the two proximal third of the spine of the scapula. Let's check if it's correct. Yes, exactly. It inserts also to the spine of the scapula here. So it starts from there, inserts to the spine of the scapula. This was the trapezius muscle. Now if we move to another muscle, which we can see in the lateral view here, and it's a very famous muscle called the brachiocephalic muscle. The brachiocephalic muscle is called like this because it starts from the brachium, from this region, the region where we have the humerus, called the brachium, and it extends up to the head. So brachiocephalic, cephalic means head. This muscle, brachiocephalic, has in the dog three parts. All three parts, they start from this line here called the clavicular tendon or clavicular insertion. So this is the origin of the three parts. The first part starts from here and inserts to the cranial surface of the humerus. Let's check if it's correct. So we will start from the clavicular tendon here and we will follow the muscle to the insertion. So this is called, this part of the brachiocephalic muscle called the cleidobrachialis muscle. Cleidobrachialis muscle. So it starts from the clavicular tendon and inserts to the cranial surface of the humerus. So here we can see the humerus hidden by the muscles, and this muscle here, cleidobrachialis, inserts to the cranial surface of the humerus. While the other parts are here very clear, the cleidocervicalis muscle. Cleidocervicalis muscle starts also from the clavicular tendon and moves all the way. Let's follow the muscle. It inserts to the median rough here and to the knuckle, median rough in this area here, as you can see. While the third part of the brachiocephalic muscle starts also from the clavicular tendon here and inserts to the mastoid process. Let's follow that muscle, which is a little bit hidden under the cleidocervicalis muscle. Start from here, and if we follow the muscle, it should insert up to the mastoid process of the skull, and that's why we will name this muscle, the third part, as cleidomastoideus muscle. Cleidomastoideus muscle. Okay, So this is the three parts of the brachiocephalic, the cleidobrachialis, the cleidocervicalis, and the cleidomastoideus muscle in the dog. Okay? The next muscle, which we can see only part of it in this area here, called the omotransversarius muscle. This muscle inserts, or let's say originates from the wing of the atlas, where the atlas, this is the atlas and this is the wing of the atlas. So the wing of the atlas is considered as the transverse process of the atlas C1, and that's why we will name it as the omotransversarius. Transversarius comes from the transverse processes, omo from this region, from the shoulder region, called also omo. So if we follow this muscle, let's so start from the atlas here and moves all the way and inserts to the acromion, so which we can find at the distal end of the spine of the scapula. Let's check if it's correct. So this is the muscle. We will follow it. Yes, exactly. It inserts to the acromion. This process here, distal end of the spine of the scapula. This is the spine of the scapula. The distal end is the acromion. And this is the insertion of the omotransversarius muscle. The next muscle which we can find here and belongs to the shoulder girdle muscle is this very broad muscle called the latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi originates from this fascia, which we can see in this area here. Let me just try to show you the origin of it. So the thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia, it's a very strong fascia found in the area of the thorax and lumbar region. That's why we will name it as thoracolumbar fascia. Okay, so this fascia originates from the spinous process of the lumbar vertebrae and some of the spinous process of the thoracic vertebrae. This is the origin of the latissimus dorsi. The latissimus dorsi, or we can name it as the broad muscle of the thorax, because it's a very broad muscle covering the thorax, it inserts to the medial surface of the humerus, exactly to the teres major tuberosity. Where can we find it? So let's follow the muscle. It should go, as you can see, all the way here to the humerus medial surface. It's not clear here. It's on the medial surface. We have the teres major tuberosity, which is the insertion of the latissimus dorsi. The latissimus dorsi, it's innervated by the thoracodorsal nerve. If you remember, we mentioned in some other videos. Now I will later also show you some more deep located muscles, including the rhomboideus muscle and the ventral serrated muscle. But for now, let's just talk about some of the muscles which we can find in this area, including the deltoid muscle. The deltoid muscle in the dog has two parts. The scapula part, this one is the scapula part, and the other one is the acromial part. The scapula part, it's named as scapula part because it originates from the spine of the scapula. Where's the spine again? Look. This is exactly the spine of the scapula, the origin of the scapula part of the deltoid muscle. While the acromial part of the deltoid muscle originate from these points. Do you remember what we have here? We have the acromion, exactly. And that's why we name this part as acromial part, because it originates from the acromion. Can you see that? Exactly this point here is the acromion. Okay? These two parts of the deltoid muscle moves together at the end and inserts to the deltoid porosity, that projection which we can find on the lateral surface of the humerus. So let's follow these two muscles, one from the scapula, one from the acromion, and let's go where they are going, exactly to this area here. This projection called the deltoid tuberosity, the insertion of the deltoid muscle. The deltoid muscle is innervated by the axillary nerve. Now in this view also, we can see, for example, of course, parts of the infraspinous muscle, and I will show this in another view. But for now, we can see, for example, the triceps brachii. this muscle, this huge muscle, is the triceps brachii, and as the name suggests, it has three heads. The lateral head, that one which we can see in the lateral view, the long head, this big one here, it's long, and the medial head on the medial side. But here we can see the lateral head. What is the origin of the lateral head of the triceps brachii? Is the lateral proximal part of the humerus. Let's check again. Yeah, so we will go to the beginning of this muscle and we will see that yes, we are talking about the lateral proximal surface of the humerus. And if you follow the lateral head of the triceps brachii, let's see where it inserts. So we will follow it down, 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 and you will find that it inserts to the olecranon tuberosity, to the olecranon tuberosity. While if we look at the long head of the triceps brachii, you will find that it originates from the scapula. Where exactly from the scapula? Exactly from the caudal border of the scapula. So this is the caudal border of the scapula. So this is the scapula completely, okay? And from the caudal border of the scapula, we will find the long head originating from there. Can you see that? And if you follow the long head, it inserts also to the olecranon tuberosity.